Hey, good afternoon, everyone. A lot of folks talking about the winter storm that's coming in. This is a little video update that we do, kind of a behind the scenes look. No, not all the lights are on and a little less formal. We can just kind of break down and allow ourselves a little extra time to explain what's going to happen. Phone is ringing behind me here, and I'll just let that go. Well, a lot of phone calls coming in right now in the storm center. We've got wintry weather coming in. Still a lot of question marks with this storm. Temperature is going to be very important, but not only the temperature here at the ground, but what's going on aloft also. A lot of folks ask, okay, we're at 31 degrees. Why is it not snowing and yet we're getting freezing rain? Think of the atmosphere. Here we are down at the ground and we're sitting at freezing. Well, in between there, there's a little area of warmer air. Snowflakes develop up here and they melt through that layer and they don't have time to refreeze before they get to the ground. And when they get to the ground, that's where they freeze. And that's why it causes the glaze. Now, if there is enough air there for that to refreeze, that's why you get sleet. If you have freezing temperatures all the way through, then of course the snow never melts and it falls all the way to the ground as snow. We've got a little bit of all of that as we go through the next 24 to 36 hours. Let's dig right in and show you all the winter advisories, watches, warnings. Notice the tan counties there. Those are the winter weather advisories. That's Independence County, Jackson, and White County in Region 8. Winter storm watch is in effect for Craighead, Green, Clay, Lawrence, and Randolph. Some of those counties in the watch, likely Randolph and Lawrence, maybe Green and Clay, will be upgraded to probably a winter storm warning or an ice storm warning, which if you notice, we've got ice storm warnings in effect through Sharp County, Fulton County, Stone and Izard, Cleburne County, Baxter County, and Region 8. Those extend a little farther back off to the west. The difference between these now, winter weather advisories not quite meeting the criteria for an ice storm warning or a winter storm warning, but enough to cause some travel problems. The ice storm warning, that's where we think most of the precipitation that falls will be in the form of freezing rain. That's where it falls as liquid and glazes over everything that's exposed. And then the winter storm warning there in Missouri, that is in anticipation of freezing rain, sleet, and snow. You kind of have a combination of everything, so you can't just classify it just as an ice storm warning. So if you've looked at our TV screen, there are a lot of colors on the map. We're going to watch temperatures closely as we go through the next 24 hours. I'll note one thing. It is colder right now than what we anticipated. That worries me for tomorrow because temperatures being colder today makes me wonder, okay, are the models not grasping how cold it is going to be or how warm it's going to be tomorrow? We're sitting at freezing now in Jonesboro 31, in Newport 33, and Searcy 32 right now in Batesville. If you graph out the temperatures using StormCast through the overnight, notice how they stay at or below freezing. That is concerning. Precipitation starts coming in here at or below freezing. That is going to be in the form of freezing rain or sleet. So here's the question mark. Tomorrow, will we really see this surge of warm air? I think we will. I think we'll switch over to just plain old rain as we head into the afternoon. At freezing line right through there. So as we head in the mid-morning hours, hopefully rising above freezing. Maybe not as warm as 44. As I said, maybe the models are not handling this too well. That graph may look something like this instead. Nonetheless, all we need to do is get above freezing, and we will not have any significant problems. This is what it looks like right now. A lot of snow through parts of Kansas. Notice a lot of that precipitation. You may have woken up this morning and go, wow, look at all that snow heading our way. And then notice how it just kind of falls apart. We've got very dry air in place here, and it just kind of gobbles up that precipitation when it comes in. Not to say we haven't seen some pockets of flurries or sleet. We have seen some of that. And chances are we'll see some of that as we go through the next few hours. Notice this radar loop. We're recording this at about 2:15 or so, and you can see the precipitation is coming in, but the low is still a little bit farther off to the west. So we're going to see another round of precipitation come in later on tonight, and that is going to overspread as we head the bulk of that, probably between midnight and the lunch hour tomorrow. You know, part of the reason we're warming up is that surge of southerly air coming in from the south. Not only will that warm us up, but it's going to bring us the moisture also. So in between those periods is what we're most concerned with. That low now is moving through the Texas Panhandle. It's going to be coming through parts of Oklahoma and parts of Kansas and moving off to our northwest. Notice that southwesterly flow by Thursday night into Friday morning. that will warm us up. Temperatures are likely to rise as we go through the night on Thursday, so this isn't a prolonged event, so we don't have to worry about that. Here is Stormcast. Notice 4 o'clock in the morning, it shows that area of purple through there. It's light. There's not a whole lot to it, but it could be just enough to make the roads slick or put a little bit of accumulation, on some of the trees or the power lines. Then here comes the big surge of moisture. This is that in-between period now where we have the surge of warmer air, but it's also the surge of moisture. Wow, look at that. We've got every color under the sun, it seems like, across Region 8. Some people will be seeing freezing rain. Some will be seeing sleet. Some will see plain old rain. So we are right on that line. To pinpoint exactly if you are going to get ice or just plain old rain is right at impossible. Notice as we head into the afternoon, we start to see that rain snow line nudge to the north. And by 6 o'clock, I think all of us should be above freezing. And any of that accumulation we had should start melting, moves out of here on Friday. That's the way it's looking right now, that rain snow line right on top of us. So what are we expecting? Paragould, Jonesboro to Newport, I think we'll see some sleet and I think we'll see some light icing, meaning roads may not get that bad. You could have some slick spots, but once again, if we stay below freezing, this all changes. I think they're stay below freezing for a large part of the day in the areas you see in blue and the kind of maroon color there. That's where we could see major icing. I'm talking power outages and some big-time problems through places like Stone and Izard County, Fulton County, Baxter County. If you're watching us in North Central Arkansas, I would make sure I had batteries. I'd make sure that I had the supplies needed in case the power goes out. I know North Arkansas Electric Cooperative, they're going to be working hard in that area. They're already preparing, but there's just not a whole lot you can do when you get significant icing on the power lines. Southern Missouri, you're going to see some freezing rain, some sleet, changing over to snow, and I think eventually changing over to some rain, but you could see some ice and snow accumulations. That's how it breaks down right now. Jonesboro to Paragould to Blytheville, you're going to see some light accumulations, maybe some travel problems early on, hopefully switching over fast. Down along I-40, West Memphis, probably not a whole lot. This map can and may change as we go through the next few hours and as we tweak this forecast. As I mentioned last night, this is a very difficult forecast. We could see, you get a 2-degree temperature change, 34 to 31 degrees, means everything in the world. Summertime's a lot easier. Whether it's 95 degrees or 97 degrees, not a big problem. But that 1 or 2 degree difference could mean a whole lot as we go through the day tomorrow. We're going to continue to watch it. We're going to tweak the forecast. We're going to get more data in before the 5 o'clock news and the 6 o'clock news, and then we'll have more data coming in between the 6 and 10. We're going to be watching all that come in and pinpoint exactly how this is all going to shake out as we go through the day tomorrow. Once again, that was kind of long-winded, but as I said, on the web, we can go a little longer, be a little bit more laid back. That's what we got right now. Prepare for the worst, hope for the best, and for our friends in the Ozarks, you want to make sure that you prepare a little more than the rest of us.